Right, Duck79 here. I am building a new costume. A bit of a change around. I'm doing the video in a slightly different manner as my usual ones. So I'm doing a secret project. I've not been doing a lot recently since my back surgery. And the power loader is in storage. I have been invited to a birthday party. It's the 60th. And the theme is 60s. Now I know fine well that everybody is going to go as a hippie. And I thought, no. What would I like to do? And I thought of the Iron Man that nobody ever does. Iron Man 1966. The Invincible Iron Man. So, this guy here. Have you been to a Comic-Con and seen him around? Very rarely. Since the Marvel Cinematic Universe, you don't really get to see the original Iron Man here. So that's the idea, was to do this. So first things first, building this sort of thing on yourself is not so easy. So I've had to create a me mannequin. Not too sure if I was happy with this, so here we go. So I asked my daughter if she wanted to have some quality time with me, cling film me up, and gaffer tape me. So she did. Thank you very much, Megan. So there we go. As you can see here, she... things you do for cosplay. Yeah, as you can see, my face is slowly getting less happy. It took 2 hours to tape me up, and when you're recovering from back surgery, it was not a fun experience, I must say. It was very, very, very hot and sweaty in there. So as you can see, it looks very much like I'm doing the old Rubber Man from American Horror Story, but there you go. So what I did was that I got Megan to put white lines on me, so when she cut me out, it was easier for me to tape it back up. The same idea I do when I do any of my armor making. I just put little lines across. So you see here? And then cut it out. There it is. And then with a lot of newspaper, started filling the legs up. So I cable tied the ends up and started forcing paper down into the legs. It looks like A-Train just took a run through me. Yeah. And funny enough, it takes up quite a bit of space. Actually, it takes up 5'9" of me, and I don't have a lot of space, so it's been very hard to fill him up with the paper. But what I wasn't so happy about, during all this medication I've been taking, I've been on a lot of steroids and things, which has added a little weight to myself. So when I was forcing the newspaper into my mannequin me, I was not so impressed when his belly popped out. And the worst case is, you always naturally hold it in a little when you've got a bit of weight on the go. Mannequin me did not do this at all. No, mannequin me let it loose. So let me go and get mannequin me. I'm gonna have a little look at what he looks like right now, because I've just finished him off. As you can see, I have a... oh, a belly I'm not so proud of. Which, when making Iron Man, Tony Stark didn't really have the dad bod, did he? The steroids bod. So the master plan is now is to my master plan is to get the yellow suit on this. First things first. Cosplayers. Male cosplayers in particular. There's one thing the first time Spider-Men they do. And it puts shock into some people. They don't wear their cod piece, their crotch protector. Please, for the love of God, if you're dressing up in a skin tight suit and you're going to Comic-Con, pop one of these on. Nobody wants to see it. I got two of these. I've not opened them yet. So what I need to do now is get this onto that you see. I usually do EVA foam armor. This time, because of the deadline being so short away, I decided to do some 3D printing. But that is for the next video. So for now, that's mannequin me done, ready to go. Next time you come back, he'll have his yellow suit on, and let's have a little look at some 3D printed parts, shall we? Hope you come back. That's Iron Man 1966 by Dax79. Why did I do a Halloween Dax79? I have no idea.